Ain't that right, Maxwell?
I don't know.
I'm truly sorry for the misunderstanding.
He really wants to go out with you, Bobby Joe. He told me so himself. Ain't that right, Maxwell?
Right. Please, Miss Pepperdine, if not for me, for Eustace.
All right, I'll do it for Eustace, but not for you.
Okay, well, here we are all together. Well, what should we do? Anybody got any suggestions?
Sweetie.
Later, Francis, later.
Isn't there a nice, long, double feature playing someplace?
I don't want to go to the movies.
What's the trouble, Fred?
There's absolutely no common ground for conversation.
Ask her what you learned at school today.
What did you learn in school today, Miss Pepperdine?
Don May Parker's gonna have a baby.
I'm going to be alone with her, do you?
You ain't going to ruin my evening, are you, Maxwell?
Why, me?
Sprightliness, liveliness. It's an eight-letter word.
Hey, do you do them crossword puzzles?
No, I just with the New York Sunday Times every Tuesday night.
No kidding, so do I. Yeah, on the back of them movie magazines. But, you know, I didn't think that you and me had nothing in common at all.
Strange, but I had the same feeling, too. One cotton candy, please.
Oh, I just... watch them make it, don't you?
A gossamer fantasy. The stuff dreams are made of.
Well, you sure talk funny. Hey, look at all them dumb people. You know what I'm gonna do when I finish high school? I am going to leave this dumb town and I'm going to go to Capital City because that's where all the fun is.
I've heard that.
Well, it's true. So after I get a job there, I'm going to buy me a whole new set of clothes and a 21-inch TV. Oh, I'm going to just have me a ball.
I wish you joy, Miss Pepperdine.
There you go again. I wish you joy, Miss Pepperdine. Boy, is that dumb. Oh, look at this tiger. Oh, you want to...